mommy?
Where's mommy?
Say hi, mom.
Mama.
Now mom's the TV. You've been raised by the television. There she is.
Are those yummy? What is it? Boom. Today is Sunday. We're hanging out at the house. Hazel took a good, she took a good little nap after church, and so we cuddled on my bed for a little while, and now it's time to address the whole dinner situation. We are making a recipe that I haven't had for so long, but I've been craving it, and I could not find where it was. Went to all my recipe books, and I couldn't find it, and I finally found it. You guys are gonna laugh at this recipe book. 5 ingredients or less. This is the recipe book that I sold in high school, I believe, for this group of FCCLA that I was in. I totally forgot where it was, and I was like, where is that? 5 ingredients or less, that's like straight up my alley. But I'm making honey lemon chicken, and today is especially a fun dinner because we are making dinner for my husband's brother and their family, Justin and Lindsay, they're the neighbors. But today we're taking them dinner because they had kind of a rough day yesterday. Their little girl, Ava, fell and got hurt and she cut her lip open. So I offered to take dinner. I just figured if it was Hazy that fell and got hurt that way, I would want to cuddle her all day and not have to get up and do a single thing. We are gonna take them dinner. They eat very healthy, and as you know, we don't. So I thought to do a chicken and rice dish. So we are taking the honey lemon chicken and a mixture of quinoa and brown rice. We are taking salad and strawberry shortcakes. I'm kind of excited to have this dinner because we haven't had it for a long time. Hopefully it's good, and hopefully they are able to just relax today and not have to worry about dinner, because I know that's just one more thing on the agenda. This might be the only unhealthy part about this meal, is you're supposed to put butter over the chicken when it cooks. This is also what makes it, in my opinion, yummy. So, another little thing we're gonna take over to Ava today is a balloon. Hazy chose it at the store last night, but I think she chose it because she wanted it. So I think when I take it over there, she might be really sad. Another thing we're taking her is her mom was like, I'm gonna get her some treats to make her feel good, you know, like yogurt, because it'll be cool on her mouth, and she really loves cottage cheese. And I was like, cottage cheese? That is so random. I grabbed some cottage cheese to take her, which is kind of a funny little treat to take her. But if it's something she loves and it's healthy and it's good for her, I'm all about it. Ryler, my son, will eat like the biggest bowl of carrots. And I'm like, isn't that gross? But he's like, well, I've learned, mom, that if you eat a big bowl of them, they start tasting like candy. I don't feel like I've vlogged in a while. I kind of miss doing it. So it's kind of fun to document what I'm cooking. Here I am again with another recipe. I'm gonna show you guys the recipe. So if you like it and you wanna try it, it's easy, 5 ingredients or less. And here it is, honey lemon chicken. Oven is ready. I'm supposed to cook this for 30 minutes, take it out, and put this flavor on top. So for dessert, we're making strawberry shortcakes. I found these yummy strawberries. I have 2 cartons of them. And I wanna show you guys my favorite tool that I use to slice strawberries. So I'm gonna get these all sliced and then I'll show you. Here it is. Here is my favorite thing. It's an egg slicer. My particular one has a little broken thing. It's an egg slicer. You put a strawberry in and it slices it perfectly. Look at this. Perfect slices. And it's the easiest little thing ever. Look at that. Those are like the perfect slices for strawberry shortcakes or a salad if you're making one. Oh my gosh, they're honestly, and they're pretty. This gets it done in like 2 seconds. So you're supposed to cook that chicken for a little bit, and then you put in lemon, soy sauce, and honey. I'm gonna put that in right now. You're supposed to do, let's see, 1/3 cup of honey, but I'm doubling the recipe. Honey is like one of Brexen's favorite things, and so I hope he loves this. You just never know what they're gonna love. So I need 2/3 cups. There. I have not been cooking a ton lately. I've been cooking a little. I guess I made those kebabs the other day. Those were really good. But, like, some days I just, like, get out of the mood of cooking, and I just, like, it's 5 o'clock rolls around, I'm like, oh, yeah, they're going to be wanting food soon. Some days I just go through phases where I want to cook, and I'm trying to eat a little bit healthier. We're going on a vacation here in 3 weeks that you guys will all come along with, and we are going to go to a fancy place called Lake Las Vegas, and I have to be in a swimming suit in 3 weeks, and so I need to eat a little healthier. I want to be in better shape, feel a little bit better about myself. I think everyone can relate to that. I need a 1/4 cup lemon juice, and I, once again, like I told you that I hate to do with limes, I hate to juice lemons. So I just do the juice, and I feel like you get the exact same flavor. Maybe it's not as good. I don't know. Maybe I'm missing like a nutritional. And soy sauce, I need 2 tablespoons. And I am a lover of soy sauce. I feel like as I get older as an adult, I didn't know that I had like these loves for certain flavors. Soy sauce is one that I've come to love. Cilantro is another. That was like the worst scare ever. Now back they go for 30 minutes. Gotta be the heaviest glass dish I own. Not including putting food in it. Alright, 30 more minutes. Hazel! Did I almost scare you? Chicken's like falling apart, it's so tender. My favorite! The chicken, the rice, dessert, which consists of Cool Whip, strawberries we sliced, a little shortcake, salad, and dressing. And remember Ava's treat.
What's Ava's treat?
Cottage cheese. And to make it extra easy on mom, everything she needs so she doesn't have to do dishes. Ava's balloon. You guys ready to go with me?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Here, do you want to hold Ava's treat? You can be Ava.
Hi.
We're looking for Ava.
Oh.
Hi, baby princess. Oh my gosh, that's gonna make me cry. Come here, beautiful. Can I have a hug? Oh, I'm so sorry you got hurt. We brought you a treat. We brought you, I heard that you like cottage cheese.
Just the large turd.
And a balloon for you.
All right, while mom's gone, we're gonna go ahead and set the table here so that when she gets back, we can enjoy that same delicious meal she just took over to my brother. I am very excited. This happens to be one of my favorites, and I'm anxious to put this video together because I don't actually know what goes into it. Maybe I don't wanna know. But I'm anxious because this is one of my favorites. When I saw it, I was like, that's that one that I love, the honey something chicken. So now I'll know moving forward when she says, what are some meals that I make that you like? This is definitely one of them. So I can't wait to eat. We're going paper products here. It's the dad way. Yeah, I'm with you, Hazy. It's just easier. You don't have to do dishes after. Thanks, Brax. Here, Frisbee. Ready? Try and do this. That's pretty good. Throw them 2 at the same time. Like do 2 together and throw 2 at the same time. Ready, go. All right. This one's Cruz plate and this one's Ryler's plate. Thank you, Hazy. Guys, look how helpful Hazy is. She's got all the silver. Boy, this is a place setting set for a king here. Hazy, are you still going at it over here? You getting a couple more? Toothbrushes, those are pretty important. We should probably have those. You gonna take those over? Thanks. You never know. I mean, maybe you wanna brush your teeth right there at the table. You don't wanna wait. Thank you. Looking good. Thank you.
Action!
Yeah, are we all done? Yeah.
Wow.
Thank you. Hazy, say, you're welcome.
You're welcome.
No, actually, I think you're supposed to start with the one on the outside. Isn't that proper etiquette? You start with the one, like the salad fork, the, no? Casey helps at the table, you couldn't tell.
Looks good.
Did you like your dinner? You want dessert? Well, I believe Mom said it best. That was a winner, winner, literal chicken dinner. That was the most well-received chicken dinner we've ever made in this house. Favorite recipe of ours, but we've never had it in this house. So guess what? First time in this house, we've never had that chicken. Yay! Not only did the kids eat it, which I will be honest, they usually don't eat chicken, which is crazy because chicken is like so plain and simple. Sometimes in nugget form, they will eat it. But other than that, like if it's chicken, they don't even touch it. Especially Brexen, who devoured his and then was super upset that we didn't have extras. So that's how well it went. Nice job, Mom. Great dinner. Hazy, I think you liked yours. Did you like yours? That's her classic on camera. So what finishes off the best chicken dinner?
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
I bought the most delicious strawberries.
Oh my gosh, look at these guys. These are dripping in juiciness. And you know what's making them sweat juice like that?
Sugar!
Loads and loads of sugar. But would you have it any other way? I know strawberries produce their own natural sugar, but you just can't beat that granular stuff.
Oh my gosh.
Put it on Dustin
Lindsay, don't worry, there's no sugar on yours. Hazy, you're being extra chatty. Do you have something you wanted to say? Oh, guys, this is what we call strawberry shortcake. What's another name for it? I feel like there's another name for it. Pound cake? I feel like other people have called this dessert something else, and we're like, no, strawberry shortcake. And they're like, oh, you mean?
Strawberry shortcake.
What else do you guys call this? Pound cake with strawberries and whipped cream. Is there another name for it? Does anybody know of another name for it?
Strawberry dork cake.
This is just the quiet sounds of a Sunday dinner.
I need like those earmuffs. I need earmuffs.
Me too.
Yep, just those soothing, quiet sounds of a nice Sunday dinner. Do bad. No.
She said bye.
She went through and said,
"Hey, where's crew? Wave to crew. Say hi to crew. Say hi to Ryler.
Hi.
What about Brex? Say hi, Brex. Say hi, Brex. Hi to Brex.
Mommy, look.
Hi, Brex.
Hazy, say hi to Brex. Say Brex.
Brex.
Why did she yell his name? Everyone else's name, she just smiled and waved to him when she said Brex. She just started yelling his name.
Hi. Hey, Lisa.
Hi.
Say Brex.
Brex.
Say hi, Brex.
Can you say hi to Daddy?
Hi.
Where's Daddy?
Di.
Hi, Di.
Hi, Di. Where's Mommy?
Where's Mommy?
Say hi, Mom.
Mama.
Now Mom's the TV. You've been raised by the television. There she is. There's Mom.
Yay!
Yeah, one second.
Boom.
Where's Mommy?
Mama.
Where's your nose? Where's your ears?
Do you remember where your ears are?
Hazy, right here.
Right here, ears? Where's your eyes?
Where's your eyes?
Eyes? Eyes?
Hazy.
Where's your button? Where's your button?
She knows all
there it is. Oh, yeah. Okay, that's good.
That's you can put it down because you button.
Kind of got a button obsession there. Say hi, Brex.
Bye. Dinner was a success. Making dinner and taking dinner to people is one of my more favorite things. We got home from delivering our delicious dinner to them. And yeah, I love spending time in the kitchen. I love cooking, and I love cooking for other people. So I am so grateful that Justin and Lindsay let me make dinner for them. That was kind of fun to do for us today. Perfect thing to do on a Sunday. Happy Sunday, everyone.
All right, so delicious dinner, delicious dessert. We've now asked the kids to put the dishes away. The faster they put them away, the bigger the reward. Ready? Go, guys. Not bad, guys. Not bad at all.
Yeah, not bad at all. You're dancing through the kitchen.
I help a lot. I think this was very motivational. It kept you guys going, kept the mood light. You're welcome. Yay! You're welcome. You're welcome. You know, The Rock can't really sing either.
Oh, he sings great.
That's called a computer.
The Rock says everything great.
What the heck was that? Rock, I know you're a new YouTuber. I know you're watching. Guys, The Rock is subscribed to our channel. I might not have told you that. Well, my wife has a crush on you and it's getting weird, so.
Are you kidding? You probably have a bigger crush than I do.
I actually probably do. I'm so shiny. I think I can kick you, hiney. Yeah. 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 Hey, don't play with that giant stick. Somebody's gonna get dead. It's not as warm as you would think, but it is warm. Good night. What is this? This is like a death tool. What were the kids doing with this? Come on, Hazy, run. Our next door neighbor, which I got, if you've been with us for a long time, you have heard us say a lot about how amazing our next door neighbors are. I won't try and bring you up to speed. You have to go back through and watch every single video twice. But yesterday, he cleaned up dog poo out of our yard. He was out getting his own dog's poo and just took a shovel over into our yard and cleaned it up for us. You all wish. Oh, Hazy! I don't think we can wait any longer. The trampoline is too integral to our happiness and to good weather. So we're gonna have to clean this out. There's not as much in there as you might think. If you guys remember what it was like when we cleaned it out when we took the trampoline down, no, that was full of stuff. Riley, am I in trouble? So if you recall, we went through and winterized or pre-wintered this place, and it took me like, I don't know, a day and a half to figure out how to turn off the water main. So now I gotta remember where that was. I'll probably go back and watch the video to remember where that was so I can turn it back on. Actually, I don't think I ever got it turned off.
I think Scott did it.
Once again, that's Scott just once again doing my stuff. But I think, you know, what happened was I needed that right tool, here? That big metal tool to turn it, and we never went and got one. So I think it's still on. Rexy. Yeah! When do you want to put the trampoline back up?
Right now!
Put the trampoline back up. So that's two votes for right now, two votes for tomorrow night. The kids did a great job emptying the dishwasher. We cleaned up the downstairs. And I think that made mom feel like a little bit of peace of mind so she can just fill the dishwasher and I can manage the chaos. That's kind of our little setup that we have. We have a good split. Mom manages a lot of the house stuff and I manage a lot of the chaos. And you bring that together and we have somehow survived to this point. She's making faces at me. Careful, wait, jump off this way. Hey, buddy. Don't fall in that hole, dude. Trampoline coming soon. Whoa, don't fall in that. Rexy, oh my gosh, you're making me so nervous. Guys, let me just tell you what is the craziest part about all of this. It's 7 o'clock at night. Just fresh into the daylight savings time. It is 7 p.m. right now. We'd be doing baths and bedtime. It should be dark. But it is bright, it's beautiful, and it just got more beautiful.
Oh God!
Oh man, I love my wife, yeah. Yeah, watch it! Ah, Brex is gonna stomp my feet. Look at this though, sunny.
Yep, you're into the print.
Yep, like I said, I did not, I told you, we've got a good system. Mom manages the house, I manage the chaos, she mocks me relentlessly, I treat her like gold. So that's kind of our thing. Oh! feels and smells like spring. Right guy. Watch out, watch out. Kid coming through. Oh, off-road. All right, I didn't know you could do that. Nice job. Holy cow. Daylight savings time has blessed us with this sunny evening, but I want to know, how have you felt about daylight savings time? How's it affected you? We talked to some people today who universally said that was the worst part of their week, exhausted from losing that hour of sleep. How has it affected you? Do you care? Does it matter? Do you notice? Mindy said you don't even notice the difference.
I went to bed early though, knowing that was going to happen.
You did start, like everything in life, you started preparing for it well in advance. I think of the people who like came in and went to bed at 2 and all of a sudden it was 3.
We had a lot of kids today that we talked to, and they had like prom and stuff last night, and they got in at like 3 o'clock, but it was actually 4 o'clock.
Then it becomes 4 o'clock quickly. Yeah, and Hazy, she seems pretty good. So I'm grateful for this because it's giving us this amazing sunny evening well into the night. We are going to go in, do baths, and call it a night. But how has daylight savings time affected you? Our international audience, do they have daylight savings time?
Well, some states don't even. I think Arizona doesn't have.
Yeah, Arizona, I don't think does it.
So
what's it even for? I don't think it's that bad. I never think it's that bad. And maybe that's just because I only ever see the positive things, but all I see.
I like the spring one. I hate the winter one.
Crew out of the street. Or right down the middle of it. Well, hope you guys enjoyed your evening. We hope you enjoyed the extra hour of sunlight. That's the way I look at it. We're gonna get these kids in the house, in bed, and then I'm gonna edit this video. Watch some TV. Thank you.